calling out all the stops for the Boyle family. I didn't think there'd be tall boys patrolling here tonight. Watch yourself, Corvo. They don't fool around. The good news is, once you get to the party, that mask of yours lets you blend right in. Enjoy your evening out with the folk of quality. Better you than me.
The doom of Pandisia has come to the city. The river rushed in when the barrier broke. A whole district went dark. I will be glad to rest. At the academy, they cut the flesh of the dead and trap the lightning from the sky. Why am I so cold? The great ships have stopped bringing their hulls.
Crazy old lady.
They say she used to be a noblewoman until her whole family died off. They say she sold them to the outsider.
How about this? You do your damn job, and I'll watch out for scary old ladies.
So.
Thank you. Going to a party, Corvo? Is that what you dreamed of? All those months in Coldridge Prison while waiting for the executioner? Wealth, beautiful women in the latest fashions, laughing and drinking Tivian wine? And what of the host, Lady Boyle? I can see all her tomorrows, and I know that either she dies tonight at your hand, or she'll live out her days, month after month, year after year, far away, even as her fine clothes wear into tatters and her silken hair gets dull and gray. Half the city can see the lights from the party, and they dream of the delights inside. Will you tear it all to pieces? Either way, it's Lady Boyle's last party.
Overseers were passing, and they had one of their, you know,
the music boxes.
So she stopped singing as they passed, and
they thought she was a witch.
You should have seen it. Ran right through the rose bushes and tackled her, dragged her back to that abbey.
And they call us stupid.
We had to get a notarized letter from the regent himself to get her back, but she hasn't been the same since.
I'm not surprised. I've heard stories.
She won't talk about it. One of these days, I'm going to take one of those zealots apart myself.
I'll be right behind you.
Thank you.
This was once the house of a high overseer. Lydia Boyle took special care to desecrate each and every room. Old friends are cut from the guest list at the merest rumor of plague. Tonight, the nobles try to conceal their indiscretions behind masks and costumes. The other families dare not make a move without first approval from the three ladies Boyle. Don't be fooled if you hear laughter or happen upon a smile. There is no lightness or merriment here. What have they done to me?
What can I get for you? What can I get for you?
Good evening. Doing all right there?
No guests past this point.
You look like you're up to no good.
Did you see old Shaw loitering outside? You can bet he's waiting for
us. Will our sisters in the Oracular Order make a pronouncement regarding the plague soon?
What most people don't remember is, the rats came a half a year before the Empress died. And the plague, too.
Are you sure? That's not how I remember it.
If something caused this, it's not the Empress's passing. That's what they want you to think.
Watch what you're saying.
I say nothing against the Lord Regent. He's the only one holding this together. He'll make us great again.
Some of us will be great. The Boyles, at least.
Now, it's just luck they found crystals on their map. And that we can't make the rat lights without them.
And we can't get rid of the rats.
Rat lights and whale oil.
Scary mess.
That's all we live for now.
Welcome to my party. I don't believe I've had the pleasure.
Do you know they've dug down on the ruins of another city? Excuse me. If you see Pendleton, make sure he goes outside to the garden to see Lord Shaw. It'll be a good show.
Careful, sir. You look like the dangerous type.
Good evening.
I need that prize.
You get your own squad after what happened.
If I could get upstairs,
night,
one of them
yes,
must have left.
Yes, of course.
Traces.
Yes. Pendleton? What's he got to say to me?
Pendleton is a gutless, lying sack of shit. I hope he's paying you well for this.